What's up YouTube? My name is Max from Max Air Coasters. I'm an avid planet coaster player and have been since the game released almost 10 years ago. And I'm excited to be building a new project. It's a B&M invert that I'm gonna call Tarantula. I've wanted to create planet coaster content forever, and this is the first step for me. I'm looking forward to putting my ideas into reality and showcasing it to anyone who feels like watching. So I know that some of these are going to be a long watch, or maybe not, but I'm not asking you to stay the entire time, just asking you to sit back, relax, and maybe chat with me a bit while watching me build this roller coaster. I didn't have the idea to create a video until well after I already finished the layout, so I don't have any footage building the layout, unfortunately, but what do you do after you build the layout? You gotta build the supports. I built these few little supports as some sort of framework that I could use throughout the build, and I don't think I ever ended up using it. Once you get into the flow, you just kind of build. In my experience, I didn't use it at all, really. Supporting the lift hill is always my favorite part of builds. Not really sure why, but I just enjoy it. And I always forget to build supports in the station, especially for inverts. Sit-downs, you don't really need it because it's underneath the station, but with inverts you really kinda do, or your track is just floating in the station, so didn't forget to do that on this one, thankfully. It's always a challenge for me to put entrances and exits on a project this primitive. This is such an open slate, and when I was placing these, I had no vision for where the project was going to go. I was just kind of in the early stages of ideas and whatnot, but nothing concrete. So placing the queue like this was kind of a stepping stone. Like, I built around the queue instead of building the queue around the ride. Here I started to do some work on a transfer track directly behind this station. It's always more fun to build a transfer track for an invert because everything is above the tracks, just like the supports in the station. Some might find it tedious, but I enjoy it more than building normal coasters. The orange track is a big part of the reason why I chose the name Tarantula. If you've never seen, there's a species of tarantula that have orange rings all around their body, and they are really, really cool. And I don't know, when I was brainstorming for ideas, Outlaw was the first name that came to mind, similarly because of the orange track, but I don't know, I settled on Tarantula. I felt like it was really cool and it fit the vibe of the ride, you know? This next support, really funky. Sometimes when you're supporting, you make unintentional near misses. I really, really had to think about how to fit this one in without hitting any of the track below it. always iffy on the idea of connecting these three supports, but I'm pleasantly surprised with how the look turned out. I don't think I can give you one solid example of an invert I use for inspiration here. The drop is kinda Great Bear-like, it threads the loop like Banshee, interlocking corkscrews from Nemesis Inferno, it's got the Silver Bullet Camelback, Talon Immelman. There's a bunch of different elements from different inverts on here, it's kind of a amalgamation of them all. Now's a good chance to walk you guys through the layout that I didn't let you watch me build. So there's a small drop, a 270 turn, a vertical loop, overbank, Immelman, zero G roll, groundhugger, airtime mill, interlocking corkscrews, little pop, flat turn, and the brakes. That was fast. If you made it this far in the video, I just want to say thank you for watching. Part 2 is going to be coming soon, and actually, no, really, just thank you for watching, honestly, because Planet Coaster is a dying game. There's not that much support or that many creators left on YouTube, so hopefully, if this one gets some traction, I can become one of them, maybe one of the last ones. Let's hope for Planet Coaster 2 sometime soon, but for the meantime, just thank you for watching, and Part 2 is coming soon.